Hello everyone, very good morning to you all. Hope you all guys are taking maximum advantage of these virtual classes. Okay, I would like to welcome you on the next topic of lesson number 3 for class 10. As we have discussed till now, skeletal system and nervous system. Okay, as per this chapter, we already finished up with the skeletal system. As you all know, skeletal system is consist of bones and cartilage. Okay, where we have discussed different kinds of bones make skeletal system. System give shape and support to our body, and moreover, because of the bones which are present in our body, our internal body parts are safe and they are protected well. Okay, and because of the backbone and heart stiff which is present in our body, we people can stand straight, we can walk, or we can maintain our posture. Okay, that is all about the skeletal system which we have already discussed. Okay, now it's time to move towards a new topic, the same lesson, but today, in today's video, we will be discussing the nervous system. Okay, we'll be discussing today nervous system. What happens when a mosquito sits on your hand? You suddenly shaking your hand. Okay. What happens when you eat an orange? Okay. You know the taste of oranges. You are continuously breathing. You are walking. You are feeling hungry. You are eating. You are drinking. You are thinking. Okay. And many activities you people are performing every day. Okay, do you know what these actions are, you know, what is the reason for behind these actions which you are performing? Every action which you perform is because of the coordination of the nervous system present in your body. Okay, I told you while discussing this lesson, in initial, you know, first two videos, I already told you that our body is made up of smell, small cells. Cells will become a tissue. Tissue will become an organ. Organ will become an organ system, and many organ systems made up an human body. Okay. So this is one of the system which we are discussing. Okay. We have many organ system in our body, but the system which we are discussing today, that is nervous system, is main system and which is very important in your body. Okay. Every action which you are performing is because of the coordination of your nervous system. Okay. Nervous system is present. Yes, you all know. Let us discuss the nervous system and parts of it. Nervous system consists of brain, spinal cord, and nerves. Okay, simply we have to categorize these three parts makes a nervous system. It made up of brain, spinal cord, and nerves. Let us discuss what the nervous system is. Okay, the brain controls everything in our body. Okay, whatever actions we are performing, everything is controlled by the boss of the body, that is brain. Okay, which is, yes, situated in your head, and we'll see the structure and everything. Okay, the skull protects the brain. As I told you while we have discussed the skeletal system, the hard part, when we touch your hair, when you touch your head, whatever hard part you feel, that hard part is called skull. So skull protect your brain. Okay, inside the skull there is a brain. Okay, and is also called skull that protect the brain is also called cranium. It's also called cranium. The skull protect the brain. Okay, the skull protect the brain, and the skull that protect the brain is also called cranium. Okay. Now the brain is made up of three parts. Let us talk about the brain. Okay, as I told you, nervous system is made up of brain, then spinal cord, and then nerves. The brain is made up of three parts that carry different kind of tasks. Okay. The brain is made up of three parts that carry different tasks. Okay. The part are cerebrum, cerebellum, and brainstem, which also called medulla. Okay. So, first of all, let us discuss the brain. The brain made up of three main parts, that is cerebrum, cerebellum, cerebellum and brainstem. Brainstem is also called medulla. Okay, let us see what these three parts are and what are the function of these three parts. Okay, as we all know, brain consists of three main parts, which are cerebrum, cerebellum and brainstem. Let us see what is cerebrum. Cerebrum is the largest part of the brain. Okay, the gray color, when you see the diagram of the brain, you will see the gray color, the gray part of the brain, that is called cerebrum, and it is the largest part of the brain. It controls intelligence, emotions, okay, it controls intelligence, emotions, memory, logic and sense organ. Okay, cerebrum, what the task is performed by cerebrum is, it controls intelligence, then memory, then logic. It controls intelligence, memory, logic and sense organ. Okay, this is the task of brain cerebrum is to perform. Okay, cerebrum, intelligence, memory, logic and sense organ. Whatever things are we are doing, whatever task we are performing, if there is a memory is concerned, if there is intelligence is concerned, then all other logic and sense organ, okay, whatever sense, you all know, five sense organs. So all these tasks is performing by the first part of the brain, which is the very, yes, largest part of the brain, that is cerebrum. Okay, then next and other, it also controls our body movement as well. Okay, cerebrum is controlling intelligence, memory, logic, sense organ, and it also controls the body movements. Okay, different movements of your body is controlled by the first part, that is cerebrum. Okay, moving on, cerebellum. Cerebellum is the second largest part of the brain and it is present behind the cerebrum. It is present behind the cerebrum and most of all it controls balance and posture of our body. Okay, it controls balance and posture. It controls balance and posture of our body. Posture means the position when we stand, the position of your body when we stand, when we walk, when we sit. The position when we stand, when we walk, when we sit is called body posture. So the posture of the body is controlled by the cerebellum. That is the second largest part of the brain. Okay. And it also controls posture and also actions of muscles of the body. The second part is also controlled the actions of muscles. whatever we have muscular, you know, the bones are wrapped with the muscles. So muscles actions is controlled by the second part of the brain, that is cerebellum. And the third part is brainstem. I told you it is a stem like structure. It is a stem like structure which connect the brain to the spinal cord. It is a stem like structure, it also called medulla, and it connect your brain to the spinal cord. Connect the brain to the spinal cord. The nerves in the brainstem control our heartbeat. Okay, the nerves in the brainstem, the medulla, there are nerves in brainstem, there are nerves which controls your heartbeat, breathing and blood pressure. Okay, it controls your heartbeat. Blood pressure. Okay, it controls your breathing as well. Okay, so brain is divided into three main parts, that is cerebrum, and brainstem. Okay, cerebrum is the first largest part of the brain which control the different activities like intelligence, memory, logic and sense organ, as well as cerebrum control the body movement. Okay, it is the largest part. It is a gray color part we can see in the brain. Then second part, that is cerebellum. Cerebellum is the second largest part of the brain. It is located exactly behind the cerebrum and it control balance and posture of our body. It also control the muscles movement of the body. And the third part, that is brainstem. Brainstem is a stem like structure which connect the brain to the spinal cord, which connect your brain to the spinal cord, and it controls the actions like heartbeat, blood pressure and breathing. Okay, so these all are three parts of the brain which control different tasks. As per the task divided into three parts, the brain is divided into three parts, that is cerebrum, cerebellum and brainstem is also called medulla. Okay, let us move towards the next, that is spinal cord. You all know spinal cord is nothing but the bundle of nerves, the bundle of thread-like structure. The bundle of thread-like structures is spinal cord. Okay, the bundle of nerves, bundle of thread-like structure. Okay, the spinal cord is a bunch of nerves, we can say, bunch of nerves. Okay, that begins from the base of the brain and connect it to the other parts of the body. It is a bunch of nerves which connect from the base of the brain to the other parts of the body. Right? Getting spinal cord? It is protected because of backbone. Okay, it is protected due to the backbone. It is inside the backbone. Okay, spinal cord is inside the backbone and it is protected because of backbone. Its main function is to pass information between brain and to the other body parts. The main function of the spinal cord is to pass on the information to the brain and the other body parts. It is a bunch of nerves that begins from the base of the brain to the other parts of the body. Okay. Other parts. Bunch of nerves. Okay. And what is the function? Pass on information. What is the function? Pass on information. So bunch of nerves, and which is bunch of nerves which start from the base of the brain and it to the other parts of the body. and the main function of the brain, the spinal cord is to pass on information from the brain to the other parts of the body. It is protected due to the backbone. Okay, the spinal cord is present inside the backbone. Okay, that is called spinal cord. Now, before going to see third part of the nervous system, that is nerves. Okay, I told you nervous system is mainly categorized into three parts: brain, spinal cord, and nerves. So, before going to see nerves, we'll see reflex actions. Okay, we'll see reflex actions. Okay, reflex actions are the quick reactions, I must tell you. Okay, if generally I want to define reflex actions, in reflex action, brain involvement is not there. Okay, when your body parts are directly taking orders from the spinal cord. When spinal cord used to give order to your body parts and the reaction happens, or any task is performed, that is called reflex actions. For example, while discussing reflex actions, I must tell you some examples. What happens when you touch the hot pan? Suddenly you are touching the hot pan, what happens? Quickly you are removing your hand from the pan. Am I right? What is that? Reflex actions. Fraction of seconds. So, in these actions, the brain is not involved at all. Okay. What happens when you are touching when you are cutting yourself, when your hands got burned, when your finger got, what is happening? You are quickly reacting to the situation. That is called reflex action. Okay, reflex actions are nothing but involuntary or automatic actions of our body in response to something. Okay, what we can say? Involuntary automatic actions. Involuntary automatic action. To the response of something, that is reflex actions. Okay, most reflex actions take place when the messages are sent to from the spinal cord. Okay. Here, without involving the brain, hence such responses are very fast. Okay, most of the reflex actions are not involving the brain. So, here response is very fast. Okay, very quick. For example, I told you when you touch the hot pan, okay, when you blink your eyes, if something is there in front of your eyes, you are blinking your eyes within a fraction of a second. That is reflex actions. Okay, your spinal cord used to give order to your body parts. And the actions is performed. Okay, so what you will do when somebody is falling on you? You will step back. Okay, if somebody is falling on you, if you think that somebody is falling on you, you will step back. That is reflex actions. That is reflex. Even sneezing and coughing. Okay, coughing and sneezing are also the reflex actions. Let me tell you. Because suddenly you people are sneezed. Suddenly you are coughing. If something in your throat, you are coughing. If something happens to your nose, you are sneezing. These all are reflex actions. Okay. Now, reflex actions are, yes, through the nerves to the spinal cord. Okay. Nerves are nothing but the wire-like structure. Let us see the last part of the nervous system, that is nerves. What are nerves? Nerves are bundle of long, thin, thread-like structure. Nerves are nothing but the bundle of long, thin, thread-like structure. Okay. That carry messages. I used to tell that is wire-like structure. You know, thin wires are there in your battery. in your television, in your tape recorder, or in any machine. If you open it, there are three thin wires you can see. So these thin wires, the bundle of long thread-like structures, are called nerves, which are connect to the spinal cord, to the different parts of the body. Okay, spinal cord is connecting to the brain, that we all know. But to spinal cord, to the different parts of the body, all the nerves are getting connected. Okay, these are like wire-like structure, thin thread-like structures we can see. They carry messages between the brain or spinal cord and other parts of the body, depending on their functions. There are three main types of nerves as well. Depending on their functions, these nerves are carrying messages from brain, from spinal cord to the different parts of the body. There are three main types of nerves as well. Okay, they are sensory nerves, motor nerves and mixed nerves. Three types of nerves: sensory, sensory nerves. The word sense obviously sense organs. Okay, if sensory nerves is there, sensory word is there, so ultimately we'll come to know that it is depend upon or it is related with the sense organs. So all the actions related with the sense organs used to perform by these type of nerves, that is sensory nerves. Okay, the nerves carry messages from the sense organs to the brain or spinal cord. Nothing to discuss here. Sensory organs carry the messages from the brain to the sense organs, or sense organs to the brain. Okay, so they carry messages from sense organs to brain. From sense organ to brain, they carry messages, sensory nerves carry messages from sense organs to brains. Okay, nothing is there, very simple. Second part, that is motor nerves. The second part of second type of the nerves, that is motor nerves. Okay, they carry messages from the brain or spinal cord to the muscles organ. Okay, they carry messages. The second type of motor nerves carry messages from the brain or spinal cord, from the brain or spinal cord to the muscles. Okay, to the brain, muscles or organs. They carry messages from brain or spinal cord to the organs. Then mixed nerves. The name itself indicates mixed nerves can do both the things. Carry messages from brain to the different part of the body, or from different part of the body to the brain. Getting? They work in the both the directions. Mixed nerves work in the both the directions. They carry messages from brain to different parts of the body, brain or spinal cord to the different parts of the body, or from different parts of the body to brain or spinal cord. In this way, there are three types of nerves. And whatever we do throughout the day, even in the sleep, all things are controlled by the boss of the body, brain. Okay, so in this way, we have discussed today the nervous system, which consists of three main parts: brain, spinal cord and nerves. We have also seen there are three types of nerves, that is sensory nerves, motor nerves and mixed nerves. Okay, so here we'll wind up. Okay, in the next video we'll be discussing sense organ, which is the last part of the lesson. Okay, thank you and have a great day.